Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to add more Waves servers to your Waves eMotion LV1 Classic Mixer. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with production gear no matter where you're starting from. Also, if you are on a path wanting to learn more about audio engineering, I have a weekly newsletter over at audiotoolkit.co that's free and it gives you some of my favorite tips and tricks into your inbox every week. So head over to audiotoolkit.co, check that out, and you can subscribe for free. But today, let's go ahead and dive in and see how we can add Waves servers to our eMotion LV1 Classic setup. Now, with the four ports of SoundGrid on the back of the console, depending on your setup, you might not even have to add an additional switch because you have four ports already there. So you could have, say, two stage boxes on the two EtherCon, and then on the Ethernet jacks, you could add more servers. But if you do need to add a network switch, just make sure it's a SoundGrid compatible switch, which you can purchase on waves.com. And then we can just simply add more servers. Now, by default, the eMotion LV1 Classic has a super powerful Wave server already built in inside of the desk. So I have my corporate show file pulled up here, and I am digging into 32 full channels, including mono and stereo sources. And I have a ton of processing on this. Not only am I using a bunch of plugins, including the PSE, the EMO, the F6 RTA, but I'm also using the Tracked plugin for system tuning. I have some reverbs and some delays in this, as well as mastering for my record or my press outputs. So I am super happy with the built-in processing of this desk. So you definitely can get some pretty heavy loads on the internal Waves server on the desk. But say you wanted to have a very complex show file using 64 channels running 96K and having verbs and delays and plugins on every single channel. Well, at some point, you're going to run out of processing via if you're running an LV1 on a different setup or the LV1 Classic. Either way, at some point, you might run out of processing on your SoundGrid server. And if that's the case, then all we have to do is just add another SoundGrid server, and then we can just continue adding more plugins or more processing or whatever we want to. Now, one thing I do want to mention is when we do run out of processing, just take a look at your channels and decide, do I need to be running this many plugins on this many channels? That's something that I'm always asking myself, is how can I minimize the amount of plugins and the processing that I have on my channels to make sure that those channels are sounding nice and natural? But if the answer is yes, I do need all of those plugins on it, then we can just simply add some more processing. So to do this, all we have to do is go to Setup. And then right here, right in the middle of the screen, we have servers. And the left side of this column, we have A, B, C, and D. So server 1, 3, 5, and 7. These are going to be our primary servers. And then on 2, 4, 6, and 8, on the right side, is going to be our redundant servers. So you can have up to 7 additional servers to your desk and have both not only primary servers for extra processing load, but then you can also have redundant servers for if a server happens to fail or a network goes down with a network connection, that sort of thing. So we can choose whether or not we want to have it as an additional primary processing server or a redundant server. Now, if we wanted to add it as a primary processing, we would go to our B and we would drop down, and we can see that I have my little tiny Waves SoundGrid mobile server. Now, this is a older server. This is an i5, so the processor load of this is significantly less than the server that's built into our desk here. But I can go ahead and add this as an additional server and maybe offload, say, my delay and my verb. So let's go ahead and do that. So we have now two servers connected to our SoundGrid network. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change what server my channels for my verb and my delay are processing off of. So if I go into patch and then go to internal, I can drop over to servers, and we can see A, B, C, and D right here. And this is where we are pulling our processing for those specific channels. So if I scroll down here and find my vocal verb and my vocal delay, right here, I can change these to be on processing server B, just like that. And so up in the right-hand corner, we can see on my B server that I have a little bit of a processor task taking place because now my little mobile server that's right here is processing my verb and my delay. So let's go ahead and take a look at those channels. So if I go down into my verb, I can go to my channel and we can see that I have my H verb here. And then on my vocal delay, I have an H delay. Now, why did I choose a delay and a verb for being on my secondary server? Well, verbs and delays are time-based effects. And those time-based effects take up the most processing on a server. So we can see that my server load right here on my A server is sitting at 50 right now. So if I go back into my patch and I patch these back into my A, it's going to raise that up to about 57% on my server. Now this is out of 100. And so we can see that there's a very large amount of processing that happens with these two plugins. So the delay and the verbs are going to be the things that I choose to put on maybe a secondary server. But you can do this with any channels that you want to. So say I wanted to have all of my additional things, so like my comm processing, my lav, my headset, my podium, all of these type of things for my subgroups to be on my B server, I can just simply swap all of them over to being on the B. And as I'm doing that, we will see that more and more processing is jumping over to my B server. Now, what if I wanted to set it up as a redundant server? Well, first off, this session is way too big to be a redundant for my little mobile server. So what I'm going to end up doing is I'm just going to open up a brand new session and I'm not going to save. And I'm just going to pull up a 16 channel session, something that the little mobile server can actually handle. So I'm going to swap over to this. And then in setup, I'm going to go to mixer settings and change this to be 16. And then once we are here, we can go to system inventory, and then we can go and drop into our even column. So the right side of our servers, again, is going to be our redundant side of the servers. Now, the servers don't need to match. Now, I say that with a caveat, because the server that's built into the LV1 Classic is significantly more powerful than my backup server here of this little Waves mobile server. So it is a good idea to have equivalent servers on the same setup. So if you have a Waves Extreme, it's a good idea to have a similar Waves Extreme on the redundant side. So if we wanted to add a redundant server to our LV1 Classic, a Waves Extreme would be a good idea. So in this case, I'm going to drop down and add my mobile server as my backup. And so we can see that my A right here is active and A right here is my backup. Now, if I wanted to test my session and test it on the backup server, all I would have to do is drop into this arrow and then I can go test redundancy. And then this is going to cause a redundancy test to fall over and do all the processing on the redundant server. Now, this does take a little bit of time. And at the end of this, you will see if your redundant server has the processing ability to take over and process your entire session as a redundant server. So here we can see that the redundancy test completed and we have our classic load and then our Waves SoundGrid Server 1 load. And both of those are good tests. We can see that they're green and they are happy. Now, if I was to load my old session and try and do this, we would crash this other server. It would be red and it would fail. So let's go ahead and try it. So I'm going to go and load up my other session. Load session. Oh, actually, first I need to change back to a 32 channel. And then I'm going to go and load up my session. So load session, no. And here's my corporate. And we're going to open and we're going to recall the session setup. So here we have our old setup here. And so I'm going to drop in here and add my SoundGrid mobile server as my backup. And at this point, we can see that my A server has a 58% processor load on the internal server that's on the Waves LV1 Classic. Now, if I drop down into this test redundancy and we start this redundancy test, this is going to fail. So this is what a failed session test will look like when we are testing a redundancy of our redundant server. And so we can see right off the bat over here, our errors are just skyrocketing. And we can see the red bars just right here. So, I mean, this session is significantly too big for this little tiny mobile server to actually work. As we can see, those errors are just in the hundreds of thousands of errors. And that's because the processing of this little server is nowhere near the processing power inside the eMotion LV1 server. So we can see that our server load is X for our SoundGrid Server 1, which was the little backup that I have here. Now, in this case, if I had an additional old Wave server that I was wanting to use, I would end up using it as an additional server, not a redundant. So I would end up going and dropping it down into here and having that little SoundGrid server be available for processing some additional secondary channels, for instance, for like my verb and my delay. And being that it's a older server, if it did happen to crash, I'm not using my primary channels on that. I'm utilizing the built-in server for the primary channels, and if I lost verb or lost delay, yes, you'd hear it, but it wouldn't be show-stopping. And that's my fundamental decisions on why I would use this in an additional server. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the LV1 or Waves or any of the other production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.